Hello and welcome to my video about my current progress of learning Unity 3D. Today I spent some time, quality time, learning how you can write automatic tests for Unity 3D engine. So basically, two things to mention. It's not a tutorial, it's just kind of overview of what I have got and my thoughts about and how I will go about in the future. So basically, short description of the tests in Unity 3D. You have two modes. You have play mode tests and you have editor tests. Both are differentiated in the following, that play, it's like actual stuff and editor stuff with stuff from editor to test. And how it looks like. The project which you see here is not mine. It was given to me from Pluralsight. It's a learning portal, online portal, where you can learn a lot of stuff. They have the project Sword and Shovels, and I worked on it in learning mode, so just for training. And yeah, let me quickly show you some clean test. I use Visual Studio Code 1 for this, and small description. So basically, here I declare it, the stuff, initialize it, and then I have actual implementation. And basically I'm populating the stuff, then I have strange stuff like wait until. No, it's a kind of refactored code, but moreover, most important things to notice that I use things like teardown and setup. Always initialize the values before it run each of the tests, and then teardown, it just destroy the objects which I used in each of the tests. So it's like tier setup test, run the test. Like for example, I have test in the loading before it runs, you see that test setup runs first, test scene loading, and then tear down. So it's kind of order, always run test setup before you run actual tests, and when the test already executed, finished, then you have another method, tear down, which garbage collect all the stuff which you have used. So pretty obvious stuff. I won't go to the deep. Most important stuff about testing in Unity, you need to establish create assembly. I don't like it, I must say. It's not so, it's kind of, from the feeling, it's kind of, it's an access to the stuff which you have in your project, and I have strange feeling about it, that is not quite not at the level when you think about maintainability of the project. So you always need to make sure that your assemblies are valid one and correct one. So it's kind of complicated. But basically, when you create the test, you have your assembly for the test. And it looks, in my case, like following. Let me just... It looks like following. It mentions test runners of the Unity. And then you have the test assembly for the whole project. And then this test assembly, pretty simple. It's pretty simple. this test assembly must be referenced in your player mode assembly for tests. Then you put it into your test, another test assembly. So you have one assembly for the whole project and one assembly where you actually run your test. And there you put your assembly for the whole project. But it's kind of, I don't know, I have strange feeling about it. Maybe it's not because I have not used to work with assemblies, but what about unit tests? So basically, how to run them? You have two different modes, and of course you have another type of tests, editor tests. Basically, this special test only for editor. I don't know. You can add. Actually, you can add to Unity menu, so you can, like, I don't know. Can you see this? Custom menu that is what I have added to Unity editor. And you basically, if you, I don't know, writing internal tools for your team, you can actually test your tools with Unity. It's kind of hacky stuff. But I'm speaking today about testing, so to speak, main features of your game, main business logic. And for me, it's kind of important to make sure that you can test it. So basically, let me show you how it looks like. You have here play mode assembly. There you have your tests. And let me just run tests which I have seen in the course. They're more, they can show actually more stuff. So you can, and then I will think about what to say about. So you can think, test if your animation works pretty well. Then you can actually test stuff like path finding or collision, or does the enemy AI works. Things like that can be tested. It's not so much code for this kind of case, but still it's pretty amazing that you can run tests, even FPS tests. You can actually write a test where you can see how fast on your platform your prototype works, and make sure that if you have production consideration, that you will be always kind of in loop how much FPS you're actually getting with the latest build. Once again, I will probably show you only my clean test, which I have written. And basically, my tests are pretty simplified ones. I just test if I can load the scene, and I just test if I can access some stuff. So basically, my test, I need to close it and clean tests. Yeah, so basically, my understanding about it, you need arrange, act, assert. Here I arrange some stuff, and then I execute my staff tests, and here you can clearly see that I can test the animation. And where I have, I don't think that I have asserts actually, no. But main consideration, it works, but it feels like Unity need to improve the work with the assembly, because it can be under circumstances, it can be pretty not obvious why it does not work. I did catch some not nice bugs in Unity 3D engine 2019 build, and it's not bad. It's not bad, it's just kind of quirkiness which you can sometimes get if you get too deep into the engine. So my main concern not to get into deep into the engine and be able to test actual stuff, and I was able to do that more or less, and here you go, actual tests. If you don't have test runner, you can always edit through your package manager. Me personally, I prefer to do that from the beginning, so having adding the stuff. I hope it can be accessed. Test framework. Yeah, test framework. So you can edit if you need to, but check it out. And Unity 3D must improve testability, because I see some quirkiness. It can be done, but it should kind of say it's not easy work. It takes some time to abstract the stuff from. You have always in unit testing, you have major thing to do, always think about how you can exactly test one small unit of code. If you have too many dependencies and you need to test it before you test actual code, you need to make sure that this code have not so much dependencies. In some cases it's quite difficult to do, and my reason to say, then you need to refactor your code in such way that most critical part is testable and other stuff is just a rudimentary optional one. So you need to make sure that most critical stuff can be tested. But it's still work in progress for me. I will drill deeper into the unit tests in C# and Unity 3D. Expect to see some interesting stuff. Basically, that's it for me. And thank you.